met Christopher Kayemba at the Boyogerere Ekireka stage in the old taxi park where he works as a tout. We, like other passengers, were struck by the way Kayemba carries out his tasks, even with his malformed hands. At 18, Kayemba should be still in school, but was not lucky enough like his other age mates. He dropped out of school in primary 5 after his father's death. Circumstances thereafter forced him to try out different ventures to get money to survive with little success, until a family friend turned brother introduced him into the business of being a taxi tout.
Baganda banga baba gobye ku masomera bato ngate nemmere tewali waka.
Kayemba reports to the stage every morning, and whoever needs his services can employ him for the day.
Abamu banyomwe kumpa taxi nkolemu nga bagamba sisobola.
The energetic young man says he is here to show people that even with his state, he can work. We followed Kayemba as he went about his job to see how exactly he works and the challenges he meets. Clearly, Kayemba's ability to execute his job as a tout is unmatched. Kayemba took off some time and took us to his home in Chirinya, Boyogerere, to show us just how much more he can do with his malformed hands. Still, we stay in amazement as Kayemba lifts a 20-liter jerrycan filled with water. And that is not all. Kayemba many times helps with domestic chores. It has been 4 months now since Kayemba started working as a tout. He says he has not really met any major challenges apart from the usual of passengers who default on paying their fares.
Abamu banda bane bansasira. Bagamba yongera okolera ddala. Banga abalina emikono emiramu abamu babba n'eggwe tobba.
This young man boasts of some achievements so far.
Enyumba ya tata yafanga lese tajukubye plaster.
Faruk Chiyimba, who introduced Kayemba to this business, says this young man has been hardworking since he was a child, despite his disability. Kayemba's workmates say he does what is expected of him.
This 18-year-old
wants to return to school, but only if his younger siblings are in school too.
When faced with tough situations, many of us sit back and despair. But desperation is not anything Chris thought about when everything seemed tough. He got up, put aside his disability, and decided to fend for his family. Gertrude Tumusime with Kware, NTV.